Hey, Hill.
Hill here.
Gaming.
And welcome back to the Elder Scrolls V Skyrim Special Edition on the PC. This is Hill with yet another episode. Where we left off in the last episode, we were to come to Whiterun to talk to the Jarl in Dragon's Reach about some sort of a prison for dragons. And here we are right outside Dragon's Reach, and we're just going to proceed inside and see what this is all about. And folks, unfortunately, I'm still struggling with this NVIDIA update of what they're now calling the GeForce experience. It's no longer known as Shadow Play, but for some reason my mic volume has been like cut very low. I'm trying to make adjustments with each recording. Hopefully this is an improvement over some of the earlier two recordings, but here we are to talk to the Jarl.
Good to see you. Hey there.
I need your help. I need to trap a dragon in your palace.
I must have misheard you. I thought you asked me to help you trap a dragon in my palace.
You know I wouldn't ask if it wasn't important.
Of course. You already saved Whiterun from that dragon. I owe you a great deal. But I don't understand. Why let a dragon into the heart of my city when we've been working so hard to keep them out?
The threat is worse than you know. Alduin has returned.
Alduin? The World Eater himself? But how can we fight him? Doesn't his return mean it's the end times?
I'm Dragonborn. It's my destiny to stop him.
I don't know about such things, but I heard the Greybeard summon you. That's good enough for me. Now what's this nonsense about trapping a dragon in my palace?
It's the only way to find Alduin before it's too late.
I want to help you, Dragonborn, and I will, but I need your help first.
Oh my god,
Ulfric
really?
Ulfric and General Tullius are both just waiting for me to make a wrong move. Do you think they will sit idle while a dragon is slaughtering my men and burning my city? No. I can't risk weakening the city while we are under the threat of enemy attack. I'm sorry.
What if you didn't have to worry about an enemy attack?
Then I would be glad to help you with your mad dragon-trapping scheme. But getting both sides to agree to a truce will be difficult at this point. The bitterness has gone too deep. Maybe. What of the Greybeards? They are respected by all Nords. High Hrothgar is neutral territory. If the Greybeards were willing to host a peace council, then maybe Ulfric and Tullius would have to listen.
Leave that to me. I'll talk to Angia about hosting a peace council.
My Dragonborn. Maybe you can stop the dragons, and this war into the bargain. Keep safe. What can I do for you, friend?
All right, Tiernan. You're with me.
Alright, so it looks like we're headed back to High Hrothgar, and we should be able to do that by fast traveling. Here we go. So I decided I would keep playing Skyrim up until Mass Effect Andromeda comes out. In almost a week now, so I will continue these recordings up until that time. So we'll see how far I can get. And I know many of you have already, you know, witnessed the events of Skyrim over and over, probably because this game has been out between 5 and 6 years, but this is actually my first time getting this far. When I got the game like 5 or 6 years ago on the 360, I just did not like it and I couldn't get through it. But, you know, with this remastered special edition, I thought I would give it another try, and I have been enjoying it immensely. What the? Oh, he's up here. I thought I had to talk to an urn.
Alduin? We heard the Dragonborn shout from here. You defeated him?
Yes, but he escaped. I need to find his portal to Sovngarde.
I feared as much. I thought it was him we saw flying east after your battle.
I need your help. I need to capture a dragon.
We are not warriors. What is overlooked in the Dragonborn is not permitted to any other followers of the Way of the Voice.
I'll worry about capturing a dragon. I need your help to stop the war.
You misunderstand our authority. The Greybeards have never involved themselves in political affairs.
Jarl Balgruuf won't help me while the war rages.
I see. The dragon will lead you to Alduin, but without the Jarl's help.
Both sides respect the Greybeards. They will listen.
Partanax has made the decision to help you. This is the road we have to walk. Even the Greybeards must bend to the winds of change, it seems. So be it. Tell Ulfric and General Tullius that the Greybeards wish to speak to them. We will see if they still remember us. Sky?
Alright, we're out. Just wanted to check the dialogue options to see if there was anything else that I may learn, but I think that was enough for us to further the story. So I'm concentrating on the main quest line for the moment. And you know, we're out of time, so you know, I'm doing the best I can to get as far as I can in the story. Okay, Alright, what have we got on the map here? Alright, let me go over here and talk to Stormcloak, and then we'll go back and talk to Balgruuf, or Balgruuf, depending on what part of Skyrim you're from. It's interesting how, you know, people pronounce his name. You know, there's like two separate pronunciations of that name. But it does look like it's Balgruuf, the way it's spelled.
Can I help you?
Yeah, follow me. Wait a minute, this doesn't look like the right place. Wait a minute, I thought we were going to,
Everyone knows General Windhelm. Tullius wields the real power.
Oh, we're going to see General Tullius, okay. Missing out
on wanderer like you must have plenty of tales to tell. But I'm afraid I'm too busy to hear them.
Someday soon you will all see battle. Did you hear today?
Somehow I thought I was going to see the Stormcloak dude, but I'm mistaken.
The Winking Skeevers got warm beds and cold meat.
I'm telling you, Ulfric's planning an attack on Whiterun.
He'd be insane to try. He doesn't have the men.
That's not what my scouts report, sir. Every day more join his cause. Riften, Dawnstar, and Winterhold support him.
It's not a cause. It's a rebellion.
Call it whatever you like, General. The man's going to try to take Whiterun.
Jarl Balgruuf.
Balgruuf refuses the Legion's right to garrison troops in his city.
You hear that, Balgruuf? Balgruuf
also refuses to acknowledge Ulfric's claim.
And I can't talk to this man.
Well,
he keeps walking by.
Well, if he wants to
by.
Stand outside the protection of the Empire, fine. Let Ulfric pillage his city.
General.
You people and your damn jarls.
Sir, you can't force a Nord to accept help he hasn't asked for.
Are my men now giving free rein to anyone who wanders into the castle? Do you have some reason to be here, citizen?
I believe we've already met.
Have we? Oh, of course. You were at Helgen. One of the prisoners, if I recall correctly.
I was set free. I could have gone anywhere. I came here to fight for the Empire.
I suppose that's true. Fine. Why don't you have a chat with Legate Ricca? I suspect we might have use for someone resourceful like you. Not many survived, Helgen. Besides, I'm sure your being imprisoned was all a terrible misunderstanding.
What is
yes,
it?
Sir.
You Nords and your bloody
hang on,
order.
This is not... This is an earlier quest.
Can I
oh,
help
come
you?
On. Dude.
Speak with Legate Ricca. She will
yeah,
determine
here we
if
go.
You are Legion material.
I have a message from the Greybeards.
The Greybeards? What do those old hermits want with me?
They're convening a peace council at High Hrothgar.
Why, there's nothing to discuss as long as that traitor Ulfric is in arms against his rightful emperor.
We need a truce until the dragon menace is dealt with.
They are getting to be a problem, but I wasn't sent to Skyrim to fight dragons. My job is to quell this rebellion, and I intend to do just that. Dragons or no dragons.
The dragons are a bigger problem than the Stormcloaks right now.
You may have a point. It's getting difficult to even move troops around without attracting a dragon attack. By all accounts, the Stormcloaks are suffering just as badly. Even Ulfric might see the sense of a truce under these conditions.
You'll come to the Peace Council then?
Yes, yes, fine. I'll come to this Greybeard Council. For all the good it will do.
Talking peace with Ulfric? You must be an optimist.
All right, one down. Sorry about that, folks. I
never could get the hang of that.
Did the earlier quest about joining the Imperials and whatnot, so I got that dialogue choice was still hanging in the air, but now that's out of the way too. And I still don't know what side I'm gonna join.
I've got a little work if you're interested, traveler.
Oh, really?
You see those warriors from Hammerfell? They've got curved swords. Curved swords. Hell, summoner.
I thought you had
conjure
some
me up a warm bed, would you?
Really? Fuck you, dude.
Got to thinking. Maybe I'm the Dragonborn, and I just don't know it yet.
Are you the one?
You look new. I'm new, too. I think you're passing through solitude. Maybe you're looking to make some easy gold, yes?
What did you have in mind?
It's easy to find things to sell. Things nobody will miss. Things from underground, or just left lying around in someone's house. I bet the two of us were very alike. So why not take the next step? We can help each other. My sister Deja and I are treasure hunters. We like to collect things.
I'm no thief.
Of course not. Thieves take what is precious. Thieves steal. We just take what will not be missed. What no one needs anymore. Maybe we take some weapons and stop a few deaths. Who would call that thievery?
I'm listening.
I knew you looked like a clever one. With the war, many more ships come through these docks. Loaded with weapons and pay, but few people, and they pass through dangerous waters. We have an interest in one of those boats, the Ice Runner. The Solitude Lighthouse will be guiding it in, but if its fire were to go out, the Ice Runner would run aground.
So you want me to put out the lighthouse fire?
What an interesting idea. I think if someone were to do something like that, there would definitely be a certain amount of loot to be shared. Yes, if someone were to put out the lighthouse fire and then meet me on the docks afterwards, I could certainly direct them to that loot.
Setting up a wreck, I should turn you into the gods.
Turn me in? For what? What crime's been committed? I'm just making idle talk about what would most undoubtedly be a tragic event. A tragic and very, very profitable event. It would be best if we spoke little until you've completed your task.
Well, I don't know if I'm gonna complete any of it.
Hey, wanna play tag?
I believe you know what needs to be done. Something about putting out a fire.
All right, let's get to the next person there. Sorry about that distraction. It's like, this game is just crazy. It's like one thing after another. It's like it's hard to just get from one point to another without all these other things coming in wanting your attention. But, you know, that's the marvelous and fun thing about Skyrim. Okay, let's bring up the map. And who do we need to see? Okay, talk to Ulfric Stormcloak. So it's interesting because not knowing anything about Skyrim, I was curious how this dragon storyline in Dragonborn tied into this war that's going on, and here is my answer, because I'd never made it this far in the game before. This is pretty good. I mean, I like how they're doing this. So I do have to get involved in this war, or, you know, broker peace or whatever comes, but you know, these are all linked together, and this is pretty cool. These stories. So now I think I'm also going to have the option about joining the Stormcloaks too, because I never came here to do that. So I'm hoping I can get through that and then get to the right dialogue that I'm here to listen to.
He's a true Nord. He'll come around.
Don't be so sure of that. We've intercepted couriers from Solitude. The Empire's putting a great deal of pressure on the Whiterun.
And what would you have me do?
If he's not with us, he's against us.
He knows that. They all know that.
How long are you
going to remember wait? You were at Helgen with us. Come to join the war. Speak with Garmar. He handles the new recruits.
That's not why I'm here.
I'm sorry to hear that. If you change your mind, speak with Garmar. What does bring you to me?
I'm glad you asked. I have a message from the Greybeards.
It's about time they turned their gaze from the heavens back to our bleeding homeland. What do they want?
They want to negotiate a truce until the dragon menace is dealt with.
I have the greatest respect for the Greybeards, of course, and the dragon attacks are a growing plague. But the political situation is still delicate. Not all the Jarls are fully committed to supporting me as High King. I can't afford to appear weak. I can't agree to this unless Tullius himself will be there.
General Tullius has already agreed to attend.
Good. We still hold half of Skyrim despite everything the Empire could throw at us. I doubt the Empire has the stomach for much more bloodletting.
So you'll come to the Peace Council?
Yes. I'll give Tullius one more chance to quit Skyrim with his tail between his legs. You think I need to send Bolgruff a stronger message?
Okay, so that worked out well. The game was actually smart enough to give me options, since I did not actually come here to join the Stormcloaks.
If you have any news of the Western Hordes, take it to Ulfric immediately.
All right, let's go ahead. I guess we're going back to the Greybeards.
horses all day long.
So a lot of fast traveling in this episode. Fast traveling, talking, and unfortunately no combat. It's really too bad. Because I get, you know, the bad side to the lack of combat is I don't get to level up. But we are moving the story forward, though. So I guess that's the only thing I can, you know, look forward to. The bright spot in all this endless talking and traveling. All right. Looks like it's back to High Hrothgar.
What can I help you with?
These people. Esper, what are they doing here? Really? Wait, I thought the Blades were the enemy, anyway, of the Greybeards, but anyhow.
So, you've done it. Men of violence are gathered here, in these halls whose very stones are dedicated to peace. I should not have agreed to host this council. Greybeards have no business involving ourselves in such matters.
This was the only way to get Balgruuf's help.
Yes, yes. Which is why I allowed this violation of all our traditions. But regrets are pointless. Here we are. Take your seat at the council table. Let us see what wisdom we can find among these warriors of Skyrim.
So, Arngeir, is it? You know why we're here. Are you going to let us in or not?
You're not invited here. You're not welcome here.
We have as much right to be in this council as all of you. More, actually, since we were the ones that put the Dragonborn on this path.
Were you? Hubris of the Blades truly knows no bounds.
If it were up to you, the Dragonborn would sit dreaming on this mountain, doing nothing.
Delphine, we're not here to rehearse old grudges. The matter at hand is urgent. Alduin must be stopped. You wouldn't have called this council if you didn't agree. We know a great deal about the situation and the threat that Alduin poses to us all. You need us here if you want this council to succeed.
Very well. You may enter.
All right, then.
This is so cool. Look at this. Look at all these people. So well done. The lighting, the fire in the center here.
Oh, am I the only one sitting down?
Now that everyone is here, please take your seats so we can begin. Hope that we have all come here in the spirit
of... insult us by bringing her to this negotiation? Your chief Talos Hunter?
That didn't take long.
Hear, hear.
I have every right to be at this negotiation. I need to ensure that nothing is agreed to here that violates the terms of the White Gold Concordat.
She's part of the Imperial delegation. You can't dictate who I bring to this council.
Please. If we have to negotiate the terms of the negotiation, we will never get anywhere. Perhaps this would be a good time to get the Dragonborn.
This Stormcloak man won't even sit at the table.
By Ismir's beard. The nerve of those Imperial bastards, eh? To think that I would sit down at the same table with that Valmore bitch. Either she walks or I do.
What's the harm? Besides, Tullius doesn't really want her here either.
Maybe so, but bringing her here is a deliberate provocation. Tullius needs to know I won't be pushed around.
Let Tullius have his way on this. He'll have to give ground later.
It feels like a mistake to me. But I'll bow to your judgment on this. But she is to observe, nothing more. We are not negotiating with her. Is that clear?
Ulfric, why so hostile? After all, it's not the Thalmor that...
Let's get going.
...killing your sons. She's supposed to be on our side?
You know exactly... No. Not this time.
Now that that's settled, may we proceed?
I have something to say first.
Here we go.
The only reason I agreed to attend this council was to deal with the dragon menace. There's nothing else to talk about. Unless the Empire is finally ready to renounce its unjust claim to rule over the free people of Skyrim.
I knew he wouldn't
be
able
to
resist.
A temporary truce to allow the Dragonborn here to deal with the dragons, nothing more. I consider even talking to the Empire a generous gesture.
Are you done? Did you just come here to make speeches, or can we get down to business?
Yes, let's get this over with.
Are we ready to proceed? Jarl Ulfric, General Tullius, this council is unprecedented. We are gathered here at the Dragonborn's request. I ask that you all respect the spirit of High Hrothgar, and do your best to begin the process of achieving a lasting peace in Skyrim. Who would like to open the negotiations?
Yes, let's get down to it. We want control of Markarth. That's our price for agreeing to a truce.
So that's why you're here, Ulfric?
Let's get going.
To insult the Greybeards by using this council to advance your own position?
Jarl Ellison.
What is it?
General, this is outrageous. You can't be taking this demand seriously. I thought we were here to discuss...
I'm still here.
Ellison. I said I'd handle it. Ulfric, you can't seriously expect us to give up Markarth at the negotiating table. You hope to gain in council what you've been unable to take in battle, is that it?
I'm sure Jarl Ulfric does not expect...
We've stopped. What is it?
Yes, that'd be entirely out of character.
Looks like my follower needs to be dismissed.
Wait,
all
General,
these interruptions.
You don't intend to just hand over Markarth to that traitor?
This is how the Empire repays us for our loyalty?
Enough. First, let's be clear. This council wasn't my idea. I think it's a waste of time. You are a traitor to the Empire and deserve a traitor's death. But I at least will negotiate in good faith. Since we're all here at your request, I'd like to hear what you think Markarth is worth.
How about Riften?
The Rift would help secure our communications with Cyrodiil and threaten Ulfric's southern flank. You heard the man, Ulfric. We've made you a fair offer. Are you serious about these talks, or are you just here to posture?
I expected better from you, Dragonborn. I came here in good faith, and now it seems you help the Empire at every turn. As for you, General Tullius, I see now that Garmar was right. Talking to the Empire is just as useless as ever. If you think you can hold Markarth, you're as deluded as your Emperor when he signed away our freedom to the Thalmor. Skyrim will never again bow to your false Empire. Let's go, Garmar. I should have listened to you in the first place.
You always were a fool, Ulfric. You're no better at diplomacy than you are on the battlefield.
Stop! Are you so blind to our danger that you can't see past your petty disagreements? Here you sit arguing about nothing, while the fate of the land hangs in the balance.
Is he with you, Delphine? If so, I advise you to tell him to watch his tongue.
He is with me, and I advise you both to listen to what he has to say before you do anything rash.
Don't you understand the danger? Don't you understand what the return of the dragons means? Alduin has returned, the World Eater. Even now he devours the souls of your fallen comrades. He grows more powerful with every soldier slain in your pointless war. Can you not put aside your hatred for even one moment in the face of this mortal danger?
A very pretty speech. But what did Shut it have up. To do with a...
If he's right about Alduin, we both have just as much to lose here, Tullius. Remember that. Now, back to the matter at hand. Don't hand me a mug of sheep's piss and call it meat.
Let's get going.
These terms are still not acceptable.
I'm sure you have something in mind. Damn.
Can I help you?
You surrender Hjalmarch to us, and take Idgrad Ravencrone with you.
Can I help you?
The Builder will take over as Jarl of Morthal.
Where do these demands stop, Ulfric? Do you expect me to surrender all of Skyrim?
It seems I have no choice but to let the Dragonborn decide. Although I'm starting to doubt your fairness. What say you, Dragonborn?
Well, I'm at a total disadvantage here because I really don't know about these things. And, you know, when I said Riften, I didn't know that, you know, was such a big deal. All right. I agree. The Empire should turn over Hjalmarch.
Spoken like a true son of Skyrim. I suppose that's the fairest deal we're likely to get.
It seems we may have an agreement. Jarl,
can I help you?
General Tullius, these are the terms currently on the table. Markarth will be handed over to Ulfric's forces. Jarl Igmund will step down, and Thangvor Silverblood will become the Jarl of Markarth. The Stormcloaks will withdraw from the Rift, allowing Imperial troops unhindered access. Jarl Layla Lawgiver will step down, and Maven Blackbriar will become the Jarl of Riften. Hjalmarch will be turned over to Ulfric, with Sorli the Builder assuming the Jarlship. You both agree to this?
The sons of Skyrim will live up to their agreements, as long as the Imperials hold to theirs. What about you, Elisif? Are these terms to your liking? Speak up! I'm sure General Tullius is waiting to do your bidding.
I have nothing to say to that murderer. General, you've proven yourself a good friend to Skyrim. I continue to trust that you will do your utmost to safeguard our interests.
Thank you, Jarl Elisif. I appreciate your loyalty. The Empire can live with these terms, yes, for a temporary truce, until the dragon menace is dealt with. After that, Ulfric, there will be a reckoning. Count on it.
Come on, Galmar. We have a lot of work to do.
Giving up Markarth is a heavy price for this truce, Dragonborn. I hope it was worth it.
Jarl Balgruuf. I assume you are familiar with the Dragonborn's plan.
Yes, I'm ready to do my part. Just say the word, and my men will help you spring this trap.
But the difficulty remains, how to lure a dragon to Dragon's Reach at all?
Well, that's an excellent question. You haven't overlooked that little detail, have you?
Ah, I believe I can be of help here. I anticipate. While you were arranging this meeting, I was busy in the library of Skyhaven Temple, an unguessed trove of lost lore. But the important thing is that the blades recorded many of the names of dragons they slew. Cross-referencing this with Delphine's map of dragon burial sites, I believe I've identified one of the dragons that Alduin has raised up.
How does that help us?
Don't you see? The names of dragons are always three words of power, shouts. By calling the dragon with the voice, He will hear you, wherever he might be.
Why would he come when called?
He's not compelled to, but dragons are prideful by nature and loath to refuse a challenge. Your voice in particular is likely to intrigue this dragon after your victory over Aldrin. I think it's very likely that he will be unable to resist investigating your call.
So, what's this dragon's name?
Ah, indeed. I'm no master of voice like these, worthy gentlemen. But it is written here, in the scroll. Odafing, winged snow hunter, as I read it.
Wow, whoa. I got a word of power just from them saying that.
We know.
Nice. Okay.
Parthenax.
You know what?
The dragon that the Greybeards have been protecting for all these years. He needs to die. He deserves to die. And it falls to you to kill him. Until he's dead. Well, I'm sorry, but we would dishonor our oaths as blades if we continued to help you.
Oh, okay. Kill Parthenax. I don't think I can do that because he has been invaluable in his
help.
Do the
right thing. Parthenax deserves to die.
And I think there's a mod that I can install called the Parthenax Dilemma that somehow allows you to not kill him. Because from what I'm understanding, that the game kind of forces you to. I don't know. I don't know if you can avoid it or what. But okay, folks, we are going to end the video here. I thank you all for watching, and I will see you next time.